Welcome back, everybody, here to Starlighter Season 3, our final game of the day for your Joined at a Livestream. I'm your host, Obi-Wan Kenobi, where we bring together everybody who likes every different type of music taste, get them to disagree with each other, and then just sit down and enjoy a good game of Dota. Let's jump ourselves into a good game of Dota Quantic for the USA! Coming up, they'll be playing on the dice side to start with Absolute Legends. Of course, it is God, Come With Me, Frieza, Sony as a stand-in tonight, as well as Mania. We'll all be there playing it for the Radiant side. And shout out to everyone in the IRC chat who just got offended. Oh, yeah, love it. Absolutely love it. All right, so let's look at our band starting off. Templar Assassin, Wagamama will be happy. He is banned out for this game. Morphling as well as Nuggasaurin also banned out by Absolute Legends. We push Chen and Darkseer into the ban pool. By the way, Wagamama, as we know, off to bounce. Puppy, he's off to drink. And, well, Cinderin, I believe he's playing badminton tonight or doing something else. So, Quantic, third ban. I'm all by myself. Where's the point I was getting to for tonight? For our last game. For our last game of the evening. Every 17 CEST, every single day we start off. But we start a little bit later on today. Had Empire delay their game this morning. So there was no match at 17 CEST. Matches start at 18 CEST. But we are back again tomorrow at 17 CEST. For all your matches, you can tune in for them live then. Remember, Talk Dota this Tuesday, even with DreamHack. It's been announced. Well, the prize pool and all the details, which we kind of knew there was going to be a Dota 2 competition there. But we'll have Grey Khan on from DreamHack and we'll have a bit of a chat. I've also asked him to organize something special for you. And hopefully it can happen in time. So we'll look forward to that. In the meantime, though, let's focus on our game. Painted Gold took his sweet ass time. Venomancer is the last one. So he's going to let Lycan through the pool and Absolute Legends will instantly select him. But Lashrak and Rubick being the counter pickups from Painted Gold. So believing that Rubick and Lashrak is powerful enough to deal with the onslaught that Lycan can dish out. Because we have seen Lycan's, we had him yesterday solo pushing by himself while four other heroes were destroying the team. Any kind of easy start for Lycan, especially when you've got him on the Dire side, is just so great. But even on the Radiant side, it's pretty awesome. The question is always, does he go lane? Does he go jungle? The biggest question of all, do you lane? Do you jungle? Because if you lane, you get your levels faster, you get your money a little bit faster as well. And then we see Vlads, we see Medallion come up. Invoker pick up and Tidehunter pick up. Still tells us very, very little. Apart from the fact it's probably going to be off lane Tidehunter. Invoker does go middle solo most of the time, and then Lycan still no home to go to. But if Lycan is going to go inside the jungle, more than likely we'll see Tide going to go that solo top, the off lane hero, which means Painted Gold has the option if he wants to grab up a melee hero that he wants to grab. So if he wants to go down the lines of that Chaos Knight, it'll be the option for Quantic. And just let him go one on one, or somebody else and go up against the Tidehunter. Anti-Mage is also available. And up against Tidehunter, Anti-Mage is a really, really nice pick. Just burn the mana and you don't, never have to deal with the Anchor Smash again. It's going to make sure you don't get ganked and you're okay. So Painted Gold, either he picks him up now, or I'm pretty sure Absolute Legends will ban him out if Tidehunter is looking to go offlane. But with the Anti-Mage pickup, they might also, if he picks up this early on, might force AL just to move Tidehunter into that support role in the bottom lane. Could be the option as well. Where Quantic, they're not really going to feel too pressured. But they might just go for that easy pickup. There's our Beastmaster selection. Get Beastmaster up. That gives them their offlane. And no, looks like Painted Gold is still wanted to do it very early on. He is expecting that Tidehunter to go the offlane. So Anti-Mage will be the logical selection, and that's what the logic that he goes with. Seems I share a very similar mind to Painted Gold. So we go into an XH bans, which also makes Absolute Legends banning just a little bit more difficult. Lashrak and Rubick, we've seen both of them go solo, so, and they're just going to focus on what they know is missing from Quantic, and that's their offlane. Takes out the Broodmother. Beastmaster will probably be the last ban out as well from Absolute Legends. And Enchantress is the ban out from Quantic. So they're also still thinking about the jungle. And this keeps on happening from so many teams that this Enchantress ban comes out in the fourth ban slot. Even when there is like the possibility of the jungle already pretty visible. But it's also, yeah. If Tide's going to go off and they want to put Lycan in the lane but still want to have another jungler, Enchantress would fill that role. Chen's already taken out. Nature's Prophet's still available, however. Prophet hasn't been picked up by anybody just yet. And that'll give Quantic the split push. And maybe that's what AL is fearing. They want to move as five. They want to gank. They want to just destroy as five. Actually, Enigma's still in the pool as well. Kind of forgotten about him. Enigma, Prophet. They haven't been touched yet. And AL will be rather cautious about stealing, like getting Enigma. Because there's Enigma as well as Tidehunter, which can have their ulti stolen from Rubick. But if Painted Gold picks up the Enigma and Rubick's able to steal that Tide Ravage and is able to hold it for any kind of decent time, then we've got Ravage and Black Hole going the way of Quantic. And some decent town push out from Lashrak, Anti-Mage. It'll come later. But they just need that control over the top lane at the start. So it's just who exactly gets to play what. And with Cool Rock in for Quantic, he'll be looking for a mid-solo. And maybe that's what AL's trying to decide. Do we ban off the side lane? Or do we ban off mid-solo? Do we take out the Morphling? No, he's already taken out. So who's going to go mid? What's going to be middle lane? What does Cool Rock really want to play? Storm Spirit is still available if he wants to jump around with that little guy. Bounty Hunter is the ban, so they still look to the off lane. They want to let the Beastmaster through in this case. Which, actually a little bit more of a surprise to me. Bounty Hunter, he is nice and aggressive early on and can screw around with the jungle. And that might be their largest problem. But you can still run a Enigma and you can still run that Beastmaster. Beastmaster off lane. Lashrak can go mid-solo or Rubick mid-solo. Rubick up against Invoker. Can kind of go either way, depending on who likes to overcommit more. But Rubick, when it comes to going for the runes up against Invoker, Rubick will love that every moment because if he can just pick up Invoker and throw him up to the high ground. I mean, Invoker just can't get down from there and have to fly out a TP scroll. It's good wasted money. And Shadow Demon's the final ban out from Painted Gold, so these teams are using a lot of your reserve time to make sure they get these bans correct. Well, it's going to be the double support taken out from Painted Gold. But first pick goes the way of Absolute Legends. They're still not sure about this. Do they want to run the Tine up against the AM on the top? Is the harassment from Rubick also going to be enough for Painted Gold? Do we even see Rubick run the off lane? Shadow Shaman selection. So support for now and AL show no more. And then Windrunner pick up from Quantic.
Absolute Legends turn to pick.
We get to see our off lane universe Windrunner. Or if we even see that. Animage. Oh, you could combine that bottom lane. There's nothing from Absolute Legends. Depending on this last pickup, Absolute Legends don't have this wham, bam, thank you, ma'am kind of like a lane which you can say is going to be a stable tri lane on the bot. If they're going to even do that. They can't take another jungle. They can still take Prophet. Prophet's still available, but they don't have the extra stuns they need. Shadow Shaman can add a lot of space in that bot lane. If we get Anti-Mage down there and combining him up with Lashrak plus one, or Rubick Lashrak plus CK, so many options. Anti-Mage can run that easy lane for Quantic. If it's just Tide versus AM, that's not a problem. CK is going to be the pickup from AL, so they will grab that extra stun, and that'll probably be enough to scare Quantic off from doing that bottom lane, but is it going to be enough for Windrunner just to be down there? Either that or they get first blood early on. Now, Quantic have been making a little bit of a move of theirs when they play on the Dire side, that they'll run all the way down into the Radiant Jungle and just sit above where the Tier 1 tower is. There's a small little nook, which I'll show you in a moment, that they love to jump in. There's Korok Storm, so it is going to be Storm. So, Storm solo mid, Windrunner off lane, Anti-Mage, Lashrak plus Rubick would be the standard tri lane to run on the top lane. As if they leave Universe and trust him down there on the bottom lane up against Chaos Knight and the stuns that can come out from him. Which they'll trust him. Universe hasn't really let him down before. I doubt he'll let him down now. So let's pump into the game. Quantic still with a couple of players to select. And it's actually going to be Kurok taking out the Anti-Mage, so Brax will get the mid-solo. So Kurok doesn't get one of his signature heroes, but Brax takes the lane which he's used to. And that's the mid-solo. Kurok has just transitioned himself from that really aggressive possibility at the mid-solo into what is now more of a safe lane farmer, which is definitely going to be the Anti-Mage. And Painted Gold, Lashrak. And 1437 support Rubick.
Prepare
for battle. And over towards our Quantic guys. By the way, the spot I'm talking about is when they walk down this direction and they hide in this little gap in here. They group everybody as close as they possibly can. And the second that somebody just goes this direction and walks past this line, they just pounce him right here. Very, very easy ganking. 1-4-3-7, as well as Universe bot lane. So it will be a try lane. We'll be supporting Universe very early on, so it will be Korok going to go solo on the top. Brax in towards the middle lane. And the wolves are already scouting out. And this is probably the reason why Quantic didn't attempt it. No, those wolves can check out. There's already one wolf down here on the bottom lane. So by having that wolf there, they just knew what was going to go on. Universe still wants the experience. He's not going to claim it.
30 seconds.
But now Absolute Legends know that they're planning on running more than one person on that bot lane. Unless rotation is happening, 1-4-3-7. He holds his own ward and walks up towards the top. But Painted Gold still hovering around this mid lane. Quantic haven't 100% made up their minds just yet. It is going to be Gold kill them all on the CK in the bot lane. Mania already throwing a very offensive ward in the bot lane, so they know what's coming.
The battle begins.
And then Sony middle lane, Invoker. Or Sunny.
Illusion.
Freezer towards the top lane, so he is going to run that tight on the off. And that leaves our last one. The Lycanthrope have come with me. Oh, it's going to be a jungle Lycan. Could have seen the guys in chat are having a lot of fun. But there's our tri lane, so Quantic, they will be running Universe down there, but babysitting him early on. And then these two boys, Painted Gold and 1-4-3-7, will just rotate. Find whatever they possibly can to kill. But they want support. They want Mani to start with. That's why they're hiding themselves. But Mani knows it. Ward. They gave him vision. That's why Mani as well as God is staying so far back. But this is easy farm for Universe if they do that. And once these guys hit level 2 and Painted Gold as well as 1-4-3-7 realize they've been spotted out. So they may as well come into the lane. Look for the deniers. Actually have a presence here. And this is the lane combination which we knew was going to fail for Frieza. And Korok holding his blink off. But Frieza, the power of the Tidehunter on the off lane, it comes from the Anchor Smash, the ability to remove damage as well as deal damage. And having such a great region to do it on. But when you got no mana, and you just can't pop anything. 30 mana per one, and he's got one clarity, but he'll run back in there. There's no point in using the clarity. Korok will burn it off the second he comes in close. And if he hits level 3, he might think about more of it. Korok kind of wants him to have mana. Because then he burns more, deal more damage. That's what it's all about. That bottom lane happening. Mania and CK, they're actually getting a couple of levels now. As 1-4-3-7 rotates for the 2-minute rune. Realize there's not much more he can do on the other lanes. And Frieza kind of happy. It's all in range of the tower. 2-minute rune will spawn top, so Brax will get that. Bottling as he goes. And this is the problem as well for rune control. It's just not possible. Just not possible for the Invoker. Surprisingly, two Invoker has gone Xort build. So we've got Sunstrike build for him. Probably not as surprising. They want to kill off this bottom lane. You've got three heroes down here who are pretty capable of dying. And Korok can overextend on the top lane. If Frieza gets a mana, then he can overextend. And then Invoker can drop a large portion of damage. Be 225 by the time we hit that, though. The third point of Xort. Frieza again. Korok just controls this lane too much, and with the boots, he's able to chase down Frieza as well. Bottom lane rotation, come with me, plus Mania. Looking for the opening, the wolves just not doing enough. The Dire trying to block it now, throwing down one of the wards on the side, but she's not close enough to block. It's too far away. She got the positioning wrong on that. Or did they? Maybe they didn't. I think they actually got it right. It's just deep to the right. 1-4-3-7 Universe and Painted Gold still unable to find an opening. CK's not really giving it to them. It's unlike a Vorst in our game early today where he's like, yeah, sweet kill, let's do it. Oh, wait, overextended. And then death. Doesn't shoot directly after. They're just waiting to go on this bot lane. They've got to get rid of this ward. If Quantic don't get rid of this war, they'll never get to kill an absolute legends. Because they all just know what's going on. They know how far they can extend themselves up. And now Boo's on CK, so good movement speed for him.
For you.
And Brax, hunting with the regen rune. Wanting to contest this 4-minute rune. It's like Lycan's copying a decent chunk of damage as well. And 4-minute rune's not going to spawn there, spawn spot. So 1437 gets an invis rune. Maybe he can make an opening with this. It was spotted with him picking that up and the fact he's moving in towards, well, actually no. They don't know that ward didn't give him vision that close.
Denied.
But 1437 wants to go middle lane. Give him their momentum there. And Kawami realizes he can't just sit inside the jungle anymore. He has to go back to base and heal up. Not to mention he's also out of mana, so he can't tank anything else. It's completely short. Actually, maybe AL can see that. The vision of him, Chaos Knight, hearing him having a crack. It's middle lane, going on Brax. First Blood combining with the Sunstrike. And Chaos Knight also, it was actually Invoker who started with the Sunstrike, then invoked up the Quas. And went into the Cold Snap. They had a whole Storm Spirit in position before he hits that level 6. They're able to get the kill. He's going to look for that CK rotation. And now he's back down towards the bottom lane. He's having a great old time. Run around, find a kill, come back. All right, try lane. Can't do anything against it. While Kurok on the top lane, he's 31 for 14. C is just never ending, and 10 for 2 is all they managed to get. Now God, a little bit of trouble, picked up, eating damage, more than enough time to really go through him. Fable as well, need that right click from Pain of Gold. Maybe a status required too. TP in, Sunstrike perfectly on Pain of Gold. Looked for the stun, but couldn't get the animation off in time. And now Universe of Chicken Mania, no shackle, no mana, no nothing left. And trying to retreat back out again, CK got to be careful as well. Low life for him, but it's come with me rotating down. Nobody from the dire side looking for him. We're able to get a kill on the bottom lane, absolute legends, after taking a kill in the middle lane. They're still with the problem of a free farming anti-mage. That's still a large, large, significant problem for them, that anti-mage is still farming on the top lane and not being contended. And Stormspirit, even though he died, now he's going to have a crack at Sony, pulling him back in again. Brax, he does have ultimate, as well as a jump up, using the rest of his bottle charge to do so. But Sony, able to live through this, just switches his Quas around, and... he's got tangos, and he'll have to eat his way through. He'll aggro the creep wave at the same time. No, not the creep wave, just a jungle camp. He'll find Pain of Gold. He was moving his way through as well. Now the Gush, come with me. Right click, nice stun by Pain. Sunstrike, again, perfectly on target. There's no Gush and no Anchor, and he can't catch up in time. So Absolute Legends unable to find that kill. It was a nice pickup by the Rubick. And a weird position for Pain of Gold to remain. And that's that problem when you try and control the runes. Rubick will be there, and if you can get yourself caught up in this little high ground, this one's worse. There's no way down from there. Same as this region here. Oh, this little guy here. Any kind of cliff position that you can just hurl somebody's body up on top of with telekinesis. Sony. Interesting build from him. So we're going to go Exalt Invoker. Then he grabs 1 point in Quas, 1 point in Wex, and buys a Void Stone this early on. The mana regen is okay, but no phase boots, there's no nothing like that. He's not looking for movement speed, he's not looking for right click damage. He just wants mana. It could just be so we can spam out Sunstrike after Sunstrike after Sunstrike, but 3.7 mana regen per second from having the Void Stone, it's okay. And probably lets him rush a Sheepstick a little bit faster. Which would be, as you can probably tell, going to go straight for Kurok. Oh, man! Kurok, beautiful freezer zone creep wave turned on him. There was still the Gush and Anchor Smash. Means a lot of the damage that Kurok dealt was gone, but Freezer completely out of mana. And he's going to be careful. Kurok's got Mana Void. And now Sony, Sunstrike coming in. Kurok, he gets hit by it. He's going to be careful with the Cold Snap. Blinks inside the trees. Hiding, deafening blast, only just misses. Now 1437 picks him up, pulls him away. Kurok dives deeper. Wonderful timing by 1437 to come in and buy some space for Kurok. And now probably give him a salve. Yeah, he does. But man, that was close. That deafening blast. Would have brushed the ear of Anti-Mage, and now they go again on Frieza. AM Void, well, get the kill. Should get the kill. Should really get the kill. He's baiting it. Lost vision. Frieza runs up. Now he sees him. Goes back down again. Frieza, no idea where to go. Maybe not up to 6 HP. So last right click from Rubick will take the kill, and that'll give him boots. And gives Kurok more space to farm. Then on bottom lane, Painted Gold, forcing a stun on him. Universe, might have to go a mini Shackle just to hold God out, or maybe not, lines of power shut up. But nice little turnaround, Shadow Shaman with a shot gets a kill on the Lashrak. And the power shot missing means that God gets to live. 3 levels up on that power shot. Would it be enough to kill off God? In fact, he's got no life regen apart from 2 stick charges. There's nothing on Shadow Shaman. Means the Courier's gonna make a run. Or he affords a ring. One of the two. And just pray that Rubick never gets level 6 and steals Sunstrike on him when he's walking around with that low life. Brax has managed to return himself to the middle lane. Up to level 8. Arcane Boots. It looks like a Bloodstone that he'll be building towards. Mania and come with me. I know the ward was just dropped there by Painted Gold, so they'll instantly counter it. Well, no vision whatsoever for Quantic inside their own jungle. And just let Lycan have some fun. Trying to build up towards that Vladimir's offering. And already got the Morbid Mask, and most of the ingredients for it just needs a 300 for the recipe. While Korok, talking about ingredients as well as farm, treads and having himself a Perseverance. And this is 10 minutes in, so it's not a raw Battle Fury. But it should still come at a decent rate. But considering there's no tier 1 towers taking a fall, it should be a really decent rate. Tide Ravage. Looks like AL want to make something out of this. This will force TPs towards the bottom lane to defend. Painted Gold and Universe by themselves will not be enough. Especially with Universe's current mana pool. And another TP coming down. So CK going to join the fight. Push this tower. Well, Anti-Mage will do the same on the top lane. With 1437, so maybe, yeah, Quantic will let this fly. Tier 1 for a tier 1. Get the last hit for Korok. Doesn't happen. Rax comes to top lane too. So yeah, it'll be a tier 1 for a tier 1. No lives lost. And more money coming in for the Anti-Mage. Now 1400 gold away from having that Battle Fury. And Absolute Legends have done nothing to stop this damage. To stop this farm of the Anti-Mage. Mass Serpent Wards, they really want to enforce this tier 2 tower. This pressure they're applying towards bottom lane, it's got to be shifted towards the top lane directly after this. A tier 1 tower positioning is now what's being gained by Quantic. They're trying to slow down this bottom lane with power shots. 1437 is sitting in range for a denial, and attempted there by Windrunner, but gets a miss on the way. And then towards the mid, and well, tower destroyed. Lashrak takes this one. But that's still a double tower. 2 tier 1s for a tier 1 and a tier 2. That's the trade. Tier 2 is worth a little bit more, but Quantic, where they took their towers, is worth more than anything. Remove off this control and remove off this control. You got no TP support that can come in there. And because of that, Anti-Mage has so much more time in his jungle. So we can make the most of that Battle Fury. Which now, flying in, is it going to be his full? Nope, it's just the Claymore to start with. Still needs a little bit more farm than what he's got. But this is what's possible now. And what's so hard for Absolute Legends to counter. The farm of Kurok. Quantic are just making sure that's possible. The rest of that team can push out. Like Ogre Club now up on the track. Surprised he bought that before he bought Arcanes or... some... I suppose Strength Trace wouldn't really matter. If he just wants to rush a BKB, that's fine. Well, Universe... I'm hearing Brax using so much value. He was using it before because he had the regeneration rune, but forcing a stun. Oh man, Riarip pulls him out of the Sunstrike. No, it doesn't. He's still in range. He kills over forwards. And now push on bot lane. There's no mana for Tide Ravage. Not the position he wants to be in, but he can TP bottom lane and pop the Ravage. Edict damage, no fortification to stop this. Chaos Knight's wanting to go in. There's the TP. Tower's already going to take a fall. Creep wave will take that. 3 seconds on Painted Gold. There's the Gush. Ravage to follow through. Want to kill off the Lashrak. Won't be enough. Stun will be there on Chaos Knight. Tries to run away Painted Gold. And 1437. The poor little Rubick support, who is now a chicken. Sunstrike will go, but he's already dead. Invoker claims it with a right click. So two heroes lost, but the remaining out of tower for Absolute Legends is removed. And that's the two support heroes for Quantic that go down, while buying more space as well as that farm, and he bought it. Battle Fury bought by 14 minutes. It's just gonna fly top lane now. Smoke gank time from Absolute Legends. Gonna find Brax, gonna jump. Jumps fast too, nice Shackle. Universe. It's been amazing.
Magic.
Leaving EG and now just getting so many Windrunners as an off lane. But he makes the most of it. 14 minutes, Battle Fury farm starts with strength, with treads as well. And this is just gonna be so much cash. Level 11 for Anti-Mage. And he's moving bot lane to push that out. Not even enough. They do so much work to protect the top lane, as well as the dire jungle. He's deciding to push out the bottom lane and probably take the radiant jungle instead, because he can farm that pretty easily. He'll have to get towards this middle lane. The moment does he have the TP? Yeah, he does. Mass open wards go down. Will they try and fight this? Ravage still on cooldown for a minute. But Quantic, again, not wanting to take the engagement. But Anti-Mage, he says otherwise. It's like, come on guys, get in there, those seven wards worth money. Go on Freezer, Shackle, again from Universe, latching on Freezer as well as Sony. Now the 2 seconds on Kurok, Sunstrike coming through as well. Gonna miss its target, but the Deafening Blast goes through all of Quantic. And now, come with me, Wolf Form. They're trying to bring down Kurok, might be enough, blinked away to safety, but not enough. Not fast enough at least. And Kaomi just keeps on running through them. Quantic, Storm Spirit with a double kill. Now 2 seconds done, return from 1437. He managed to steal it from Chaos Knight. And now they want Sony, so for the price of the Anti-Mage, they get 4 kills for everybody else. Did there was any other buybacks during that? No, there was not. Now, Seven Wars will disappear in the middle lane, so they don't get the farm from that. But 4 heroes for the price of an AM. Worth it after AM spent all of his cash anyway. Well, the rest of Quantic need their money and levels. AM died very early on in that. So he gets very, very little and painted gold. Oh, good club is there. What recipe was on that curry? Was that just his wand? Yeah, it's magic wand. And Brax. 700 more gold and he will have enough to get that bloodstone. I kind of wanted to keep the CS hidden for a little bit, guys, just because I knew that this kind of thing is going to happen. 114 now, nice initiation, but they need that stun as well. Without the decent timing of the stun, and while Brax has even a half chunk of mana. Just can't do anything about it. Now the initiation on top lane. 2 seconds stun from 1437. That's how you use a CK. Stun to get a kill. Killing off Lycanthrope. And Korok. 1437 trying to live now. Or maybe not. Wonderful meteorite with the Sunstrike. Pick up by 1437. Buys a little bit of time for the blink away from Korok. But he's going to burn from the Invoker. And then 1437 takes a fall as well. Now that's not worth it. Lycan kill or not. Second time they've lost Anti-Mage. And this money goes out the window. He's 1-2-4. 4 kills as well for the Invoker. And that's going to give him... Is he going to build Phase Boots still? He's got 4-staff and Yulceptor to start with and 4-staff. He's not rushing that side device like I thought he might. And goes for the extra disable early on. And in fact, yep, 4-staff flying up plus a drum recipe. And the drums is for Mania. Or is it? No, it's for Chaos Knight. Chaos Knight drums. And Sony will have the 4-staff fully completed as well. So movement speed for all. Universe has completed up the mech for Quantic. Just want to keep my eyes so closely on Kurok's farm. As well as Brax. Now he's only 300 short of having the Bloodstone. That regeneration's great for him. 1437 going pretty raw, looking for the 18-minute room, which will spawn top. There's a haste rune stolen by CK. And Brax knows it too. He's using all of his mana to get away from this. Now 1437. Fade Bob, pick up, throw him down. Support coming in from Painted Gold. There's too hard to follow him down. 4 seconds stun. And then, man, that Sunstrike and Gush. Sunstrike perfectly on target again from Sony. And that's almost a max Sunstrike. 475 damage gets a flood on down. for Rubick with that low life. He loses so much. Korok now moving up towards the top lane. 1,200 gold for him. Where does he go next? Do we look at a little bit more defensive for him, realizing that Absolute Legends are doing a lot of damage? Or are we looking at something different? Painted gold. Split up to clear off the tree so he can have a look into Roshan. Letting off another Split Earth, and there's our Static Remnant from Brax. Gets the vision in that way. Sunstrike, middle lane again. Third death now for Korok. Long way out. And that's that Max X sort of Invoker being used with a different combination to what is normal. Most of the time you see like an SD or something like that, but then again, that buys time if Andy Mage wants to blink back out again. Just spam that blink button for all dear life. Well, the setup's done, which can come from CK. That's already got its damage, which comes with it. And they combine it with the Gush. Sunstrike and go from there. Invoker gets a kill on the tower. Some more cash for the Invoker. Maybe he can finish up treads or something. Move faster than normal boots. Maybe just not care about it. So gold TP top lane still. Roshan's available for all. And we are hitting that point when both teams are capable of doing it. Especially Absolute Legends. Because of this guy, Medallion plus Vladimir's Offering. Kombi can currently solo Roshan. Brax on the bottom lane now has Bloodstone. Oh, actually, no, he needs his creep wave. It's 1100 he needs, a Vitality Booster. And then he's got it. But he has to get out of here right now before this happens. Yule Scepter, Sunstrike, as well as that. Just such a great combo. Notice Tornado's not a guaranteed pickup, especially for positioning wise, when they're going to come down. They get the Sunstrike right, and Mania quick on the fingers as well. They're able to get the Hex directly after. And that sets back the Bloodstone. And only by an extra 200 gold, but that's another minute and a half, maybe 2 minutes that we don't see Storm Spirit with that Bloodstone. Now top lane, 1437. He needs to get the pickup right. Pickup God, blink in, and the burn. AM ulti not enough because they didn't take enough mana off God. 3 seconds stun, then stolen by 1437. So the damage time is there. At the same time, Lashrak dies in the middle lane. Invoker there again. They get a gank on the top lane up against the Chaos Knight, but then the mid push comes. Wards go up from Mania, only level 1, but there's still enough, especially with Come With Me. Alacrity onto him, and combining it with the Howl and the Wolves. They already take out the tier 3 towers, so 21 minutes in, Feybot will fly, Power Shot as well. Come With Me, getting shackled up, picked up, thrown back in range of the tier 4 tower, painted gold, maybe in time, yet he does, forcing a stun by 1437, and follow a Split Earth, able to do the job. Power Shot gonna go through Mania, Meteorite Force pretty harshly there on Quantic. Brax forced holding himself out, so he might stop burning for a moment. Then he can bottle up, and Lashrak try to follow through and get the kill. Maybe Korok blinks in, he cannot kill Freezer in time. And he knows it as well. Sony will also TP out. There's no AM only to cancel off any of these TPs. So Absolute Legends, even though they take the tier 3 tower, they also took range racks. But they lost a little bit for it. Decided range racks was the easier one to bring down. Lower armor so you can kill it off faster. And if you press for time, you don't think you can really pick off a lot. It's your better bet to go for. Try and bring down that range racks. Korok just transitions himself to farming another. Well, he knows that Brax needs to farm. Well, that's a Bloodstone finally done. It's actually probably a good thing that Brax didn't pick up his Bloodstone until now, because with all the deaths going their way, yeah, he would have lost so many of his charges so early on and worked so hard to get him back again. Because Korok's not going to be helping him for the near time. Korok's lane control, farm ready in jungle, and that's it. As a tactical line being drawn by Sony. Push top lane, guys! It's tier 2 tower! Let's take it! Go, go! GG! 1700 life points are ready for that CK. So hard to bring him down. They can remove his damage at least. To the power of Feybolt. And if they get lucky too, the Chaos Bolt. He's got some good stun, but 1437. He's only got a couple of seconds left. Maybe 20 seconds left of having that Chaos Bolt. They'd like Absolute Legends to push in. He doesn't want to get too close. But wants to throw out the stun anyway. Yeah, he's out of time. I'll have to steal something new before the next fight. Come with me. Man, this is ballsy from him. Must have smoked to get in there because the Dire of a War, so they should have had vision of what he's doing. And there goes the ping. They kind of know that Roshan's going to be happening. He's lost one of his wolves. He can't resummon for another 14 seconds, but that Lifesteal Medallion buys him all the time in the world. Brax, will he jump in? There goes Roshan. He doesn't jump in, he doesn't feel it happening. So Roshan will be sniped off by the Lycanthrope. So tough times coming out now for Quantic. Just losing little bit after little bit. I managed to gain back a lot through the last engagement. It's up and down a lot. But Lycan with that Aegis, with the Aegis the Immortal now, it's going to make these fights even harder. But the farm that can come out from Korok, that's what makes it good for them. Almost 200 CS for Korok. Blinks down, and they know he just blinked. The wolves are watching him so closely. And then he blinks up and into Mania. Mania gets the Hex. He's got to follow up maybe he doesn't. You're thinking about Shackle. But if he stuck around, the universe would have got that. Now the Shackle doesn't latch freeze into anything. Korok blinks back up to safety. Split Earth Stun won't hit. 1437 picks up Kalmi, dropping it down. Going to hold him out of the fight for the moment. And then Fae bolting down these wolves. Brax, you can probably get rid of this last one, but he's still trying to farm in the midst of all this as well. And then Korok will take him. And that should be his Mana Style. Yeah, it is. Courier flying it out, so Mana Style done for him. Level 16, so 3 points in that Mana Void. He'll be so careful for Absolute Legends. The initial hit from them is great. CK with his stun, then Tynander as well with his Ravage. Anger Smash, gosh, everything else they want. Long jump in by Brax, pulling in Sony. He jumps back out again. Frieza. Moving so damn fast. Drums up on him. To mention, I think, the tail end of a haste rune. Which kind of looked like it. It's just moving at that speed. Now push in the middle lane. Ravage is up, so hey, why not? Lycan only returns in 3 seconds. Everything is up for Absolute Legends. They can force this last melee Rax. Universe will slow it down however they can. Static Remnants will do the same. At the same time, while Korok just does not care, he just keeps farming. That's his job. The job of Quantic is to delay this. 2 Static Remnants. Wolf goes in, takes care of one. And the other one just times out. Brax doesn't want to get too close. He knows while the Wolf is up on the higher ground, there's vision. Which means CK can get the Sudden Reality Rift and not have it broken. Freezer straight in. Wards go down as well. Anti-Mage is making his move back again. Doesn't want to jump in through the rear. Yule set to start at Sunstrike as well as Meteorite. Just disintegrates 1437. Instant buyback. They want to force him back out of the base. And Quantic kind of realized this mid-ranks was going to go down at one point. Had to accept that fact. Didn't want to lose anybody for it. And Korok, this is the uncontestable farm, and this is what Quantic have done so many times in the past. It's not what we're used to from them. Quantic are one of these teams which kind of progress from just Korok farming and carrying later in the game. Doesn't matter your deficit, any mage can do it. Dire's top tower. But Korok, the pressure is being applied too fast. He just cannot get the level of farm he needs. He's got to get to this top lane defender. Power shop, but look at the creep wave, still with decent life. Wolves come up, they don't even need the creep wave. Feybolt flies through. If they want to force that, they could have easily. Aldi is still there for Tide, he's got his own four staff. So he can get himself into position. Well, four staffed in by Invoker, turn around, four staff himself back out again after the Ravage has already happened. Painted Gold gets a half decent stun. Power shot will fly through as well, so they get rid of the creep wave. Store fortification available. Fae Bolt, Shackle, Lashes, Freezer. Maybe an opportunity. Korok comes in. He wants to rifle him down. Be careful of that Ravage. Got to burn the mana. Now the Ravage will pop. At the same time, Korok tried to blink away, but Mania comes down on top of him. Reality won't go. Now Will pulling Korok in, but he jumps back at him. 1437 burning from the Meteorite and Sunstrike. Shackle latches up only for a moment. A moment is all they need to bring down God. Is there an AM on it? Yeah, there is. It is 4 heroes lost. For the price of a Lashrak, now going on Korok, but come on me, pull back in again. His ulti will wear off. Kurok wants another swipe and he's going to get it. Aegis Immortal goes down. Universe, stick charges so he can shackle up anything. Maybe a mini one, but a mini one power shot, that'll do the damage. Rubick with the last right click. Not only do they take out the Aegis, but they take out all of Absolute Legends. Was there even a buyback during that? No, there wasn't. Rubick bought back during the last mid engagement. But nothing after that point. Entire team wipe against Absolute Legends. And the damage was just beautiful in the end. And it wasn't just the enemy getting killed. He got two out of that. But Rubick picked up one, Storm picked up one. And not to mention, with five heroes going down, that's now six charges in Storm Spirit's Bloodstone. Things are starting to rack up. And Animage is about to hit 300 CS. Oh, man. 2.6k. And looks like he's going to go BKB very early on as well. Still want to give massive props to what Invoker has been able to achieve. Whoop, hello, blink up by Mania. Wards go down, holding Kurok in position. Sunstrike, yeah, it's too late. Needed to be cast earlier. So Kurok was able to get himself away. He's only got 1 point in spell shield. Can't surprise him when the Master of Magic is there. But not surprising when you got Lycan as well as CK on your ass. Physical damage. And Brax finding his farm on the bottom lane now. 2.2k for him. Probably try and get himself up. Well, he could go multiple ways. He already got the Bloodstone, but he's trying to get a little bit of disabled. Do we look at the Orchid for him? Try and get himself in there to shut down Sony. Get rid of those Invoker abilities. And they've been causing absolute havoc during the engagements. And having that Aghanim Scepter is going to cause even more troubles. Sanjay, up for God. For Heaven's Halbert. Are we coming up for him? Double damage, Storm jumps down. There's nobody here. I think he's just hoping somebody was, but I think the TP happened just at the right time. Absolute Legends, round two. Top lane. They want to go in again. Maybe now there's a little bit more strength and a maim ability up on God. They might feel they've got what it takes. BKB didn't like it as well. And Quantic, they don't really have a lot to play around with this, but the fact that BKB is up on top of Kurok, that's going to be a big change for him. And Kurok, if you realize this push on the top is happening, he'll jump back in this middle lane, give some momentum, and maybe they can even take a tier 2 tower as the trade. Absolute Legends, they've got to move fast before the TP from Kurok can happen. He's already given momentum to that middle lane. That's their problem. Shaka will fly, won't latch, even though that wolf was almost in a perfect position for it. TP's back from Kurok. He can BKB and jump. Doesn't matter if there's a Ravage or not, even if Ravage is up. There's a jump down, jump back up again. Kurok, now the BKB will pop. He wants Mania. Wonderful Shackle from Universe. Both Frieza as well, Sony held in position. Still no Ravage possibility. Frieza, he wants it, but there's no, maybe Kurok. There it is. Gets a stun, come with me, gets a beat down. Sunstrike perfectly on top of the Animage. He'll go down. 75 seconds on the sideline. And this is a big opening for Absolute Legends. They made a huge hole in Quantic. Maybe even a bigger one with Storm Spirit going to go down. They have hurt a lot, and look at Storm! Brax, right in, Yule Scepter instantly, power shot through, still can't get the kill on Frieza. Jumps up away from Come With Me. Come With Me use a medallion on Brax, means they can bring him down faster. EMP will burn, but Brax far enough away. They're holding their top Brax. Universe, reality rifted in, 4-star, saw the 3-second stun. In range of those tier 4 towers. Fortification buys time, Windrunner buyback. Shackle needs to latch, can do so as well. Gets it on Frieza, power shot through, pull back in on Mania. Be his death in the moment. Windrunner can take care of that. Mania runs up high, he does go down. And TP out by God. Brax can't get in close enough. As he ran out of mana. And now they know Sony is here. Pulsing, Edicting, gets through the creep wave, but Sony's away. So no point letting it fly any further. What the hell? Dire's middle tower is under two attack. Random attack animations flying that way. Sunstrike. Again, harassment central. And Sony can just keep invoking. Just switch, invoke, go. 322 CS. What is our goal per minute? 535. For our Animage. Net worth is pretty high for him, but the biggest problem they're having is Storm Spirit. He is the fifth slot in the net worth. Down to 10 charges on his Bloodstone. 3.2k gold on him. Versus Invoker again with those Sunstrikes. It's a bottom lane. Yeah, he's looking for Kurok. Kurok's looking for him. Nice tornado. Now CK can follow up with a stun, but Mana Silent BKB. CK, you're dead. AM Oli would finish him off, and in fact, he wants the Invoker, and he claims the Invoker. The illusions are following down a little bit further. Mania with a stun, finding out Universe. At the same time, well, Kurok, that's the wrong way to go. If he jumps back up again, no! He's in the midst of the team with no BKB. Mana's on cooldown, he can blink again, but he's a chicken, so he can't blink anywhere. Oh, man. Oh, man, Kurok. He wanted the kill, and Absolute Legends capitalize. Push as fast as they can. Push it through the bottom. Top lane's already been damaged. 63 seconds they've got. And they're making a beeline for that bot tier 3. And they should make a very quick beeline. Creep wave's already up with them. Two creeps. And that cancels the backdoor regen. So in we go. Serpent wards go down. They want to mega creep it. And it'll be the tier 3 tower to go first. They're not familiar racks. They might even take range racks on the top. 35 seconds now left for Animage. 1437 trying to move up any kind of damage. Four stuff up from Freezer. Looking for one, but yeah, they're going to rotate straight top. If they can catch 1437, they'll kill him. But they want the range racks more than anything else. Shackle won't latch. Nice Ravish to pop off. Mania currently being pulled in by Brax. He's got his own BKB up. We have finished off Mania. In fact, yes, he does. And maybe even follow up a little bit more. Freezer, he's caught in the midst of everything. It's still Mega Creeps going up against Quantic. But they want to fight it. Four stuff away. Painted Gold. He's going to get away from coming. But Brax, body blocking at the BKB Lycan. Now the pickup can happen. Four stuff up. Telekinesis off cooldown. Power Shot's already hit. And then Feybolt drops into the deck. Well, Korok, he's out and about. And he sees Sony. Blink down. Right click. AM Alderman will kill him off, but he can't see Sony. He needs vision. Power Shot won't go. And Kurok wants to make a race for the middle lane. But he doesn't have enough life to tank up against these mega melee creeps. It's just too much. And Sunstrike, perfectly on. CK with a stun. Flies up. 3 seconds still on it, but he cannot get in there in time. One creep will follow up and go, yep, can't do anything more with that. Damage wasn't enough. And Quantic now have no base. Couple of straggling buildings. Tier 4 towers remain. But that is all. It's just that one moment where Kurok gets caught out in the lane. Remember as well, for those guys that get a little bit confused with the names, Kuro or Kurokai, the guy that plays Mouse Balls is not Kurok. They're different. And Koronity was an older guy. I think Painted Gold, was he being hunted by that Sunstrike? I think he was. He's just juking around as far as he can. And Painted Gold gets back to base safely. I know you guys are trolling in the chat, but for the guys in the chat who troll that and they confuse the living crap out of everybody else, I feel like I need to explain that for the people who are watching. In we go for Roshan. Such great negative armor. Forge Spirits plus the Gush. They go nuts on that. And now Lycan Morph's going to come in, and Medallion of Courage from Come With Me will help out. And again, negative armor. Just dropping him. And that's going to give Aegis the Immortal to Come With Me. And the final push shall begin. The walk into Quantic's face. And Quantic, they have to try and stand firm. Not a single buyback available for anybody. Everything says no. 98 gold away for the Windrunner, however. The buyback cost is too expensive. Feybot at least gets rid of the damage out from this creep wave, but they're still tanky as hell. And with a smoke, they've moved in so far. Invis Rune, in fact, up on Chaos Knight. And Storm Spirit jumping out. There goes our Ravage. Ravage stolen by 1437. Can be turned around, four staffed up. Now pops the Ravage out and the rest of Absolute Legends. But too many have gone. Absolute Legends. They've managed to bring down Animage. Latrax followed through. And this will be GG. It was GG when the racks went down. But Absolute Legends needed to ensure they win it. Aegis the Immortal is what they required. Universe will hide inside the base. Actually, he's going to four-star Sony in and then try and power shut him down. Well, that's going to be GG. 27 to 20 in the end of our games for today. We shall be returning tomorrow at 17 CEST. Our first game for the 29th scheduled will be, Mousesports going up against NextKZ. NextKZ also playing up against Quantic. The Mouse versus CLG. It's a bit of a mousy day tomorrow. And then EG going up against Moscow 5. Quantic versus Skone has been confirmed as well as a wildcard match. So there will be another 5 games again tomorrow for your viewing pleasure. Was meant to be 5 games today, but the first game from Empire was Wildcatter, which means we'll see that at a later date. Remember, Star Ladder starts at 17 CEST every single day and will continue until Wednesday with a couple of extra days at the end, just in case things don't go 100% right. We'll have those extra days at the end. And ESWC qualifiers, if you haven't heard about it yet, America is now allowed to participate in the ESWC qualifiers, and that will be opening up for registration on Monday night. It should be available then over at joydota.com. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you all on the live stream tomorrow at 17 CEST.